A meteor shower is a celestial event in which a number of meteors are observed to radiate, or originate, from one point in the night sky called radiant. These meteors are caused by streams of cosmic debris called meteoroids entering Earth's atmosphere at extremely high speeds on parallel trajectories. You don't need any special equipment or a lot of skills to view a meteor shower. Even though all you really need is a clear sky, lots of patience, and our handy interactive meteor shower sky map, with a visibility conditions meter to see a meteor shower. The following video can help maximize your shooting star viewing experience. The Eta Aquarids peak during early May each year. Eta Aquarid meteors are known for their speed, with the meteors traveling at about 148,000 meters per hour into Earth's atmosphere. Fast meteors can leave glowing trains, incandescent bits of debris in the wake of the meteor which last for several seconds to minutes. In general, about 30 Eta Aquarid meteors can be seen per hour during their peak. The Eta Aquarids are viewable in both the northern and southern hemispheres during the pre-dawn hours. The southern hemisphere is preferable for viewing the Eta Aquarids. The northern hemisphere has an hourly rate of only about 10 meteors. This is due to the viewing location of the radiant from different latitudes. The constellation of Aquarius, home to the radiant of the Eta Aquarids. It is higher up in the sky in the southern hemisphere than it is in the northern hemisphere. In the northern hemisphere, Eta Aquarid meteors can more often be seen as Earth grazers. Earth grazers are long meteors that appear to skim the surface of the Earth at the horizon. Meteors come from leftover comet particles and bits from broken asteroids. When comets come around the Sun, they leave a dusty trail behind them. Every year Earth passes through these debris trails, which allows the bits to collide with our atmosphere where they disintegrate, to create fiery and colorful streaks in the sky. The object responsible for the Eta Aquarid meteor shower, that is, its parent comet, is the famous Halley's Comet. This comet is in a retrograde orbit around the Sun. That means it runs around the Sun in the opposite direction from Earth and all the other planets. As a result, we pass near its path twice, one time along the outbound portion of the comet's orbit. That happens every early May, causing the Eta Aquarid meteor shower. The other time is along the inbound portion of the comet's orbit, and that passage causes the Orionid meteor shower in late October of each year. Halley is often called the most famous comet because it marked the first time astronomers understood comets could be repeat visitors to our night skies. Astronomers have now linked the comet's appearances to observations dating back more than 2,000 years. The pieces of space debris that interact with our atmosphere to create the Eta Aquarids originate from Comet 1P/Halley. Each time that Halley returns to the inner solar system, its nucleus sheds a layer of ice and rock into space. The comet, officially called 1P/Halley, is named after English astronomer Edmund Halley, who examined reports of a comet approaching Earth in 1531, 1607, and 1682. He predicted the orbit of the comet through past observations of comets, suggesting that these sightings were in fact all the same comet. It has been sighted for millennia. This comet is even featured in the Bayeux Tapestry, which chronicles the Battle of Hastings in 1066. Halley was last seen in Earth's skies in 1986 and was met in space by an international fleet of spacecraft. It will return in 2061 on its regular 76-year journey around the Sun. Halley's connection to meteor showers. Each time Halley returns to the inner solar system, its nucleus sprays ice and rock into space. This debris stream results in 2 weak meteor showers each year, the Eta Aquarids in May and the Orionids in October. Size of Comet Halley. Halley's dimensions are about 9.3 by 5 miles. It is one of the darkest, or least reflective, objects in the solar system. It has an albedo of 0.03, which means that it reflects only 3% of the light that falls on it. Orbit of Comet Halley. Comet Halley moves backward, opposite to Earth's motion, around the Sun in a plane tilted 18 degrees to that of the Earth's orbit. Halley's backward, or retrograde, motion is unusual among short-period comets, as its greatest distance from the Sun, aphelion, is beyond the orbit of Neptune. Halley's orbit period is, on average, 76 Earth years. This corresponds to an orbital circumference around the Sun of about 7.6 billion miles. The period varies from appearance to appearance because of the gravitational effects of the planets. The radiant, the point in the sky where the Eta Aquarids seem to emerge from, is in the direction of the constellation Aquarius. The shower is named after the brightest star of the constellation, Eta Aquarii. Meteor shower radiants are sometimes misunderstood by casual meteor watchers. You don't need to know where they are to watch a meteor shower. That's because the meteors fly every which way across the sky, in front of numerous constellations. However, the higher a shower's radiant appears in your sky, the more meteors you're likely to see. For the Eta Aquarids, the radiant soars highest in the nighttime sky just before dawn. That's one of the reasons why you can expect to see the most meteors in the wee morning hours. How can you see the Eta Aquarid meteor shower? The constellation for which a meteor shower is named only serves to aid viewers in determining which shower they are viewing on a given night. The Aquarius constellation is not the source of the meteors. Don't look directly at Aquarius to see the meteors, as they will be visible across the night sky. Make sure to move your gaze around to nearby constellations as meteors closer to the radiant have shorter trains and are more difficult to spot. If you only look at Aquarius, you might miss the more spectacular Eta Aquarids. For the best view of the Eta Aquarid meteor shower, go to the darkest possible location, lean back and relax. You don't need any special pieces of equipment like telescopes or binoculars, as the secret is to take in as much sky as possible and allow at least 30 minutes for your eyes to adjust to the dark. Avoid using your phone and make sure you have a red light setting on flashlights to preserve your night vision. Once you have found your viewing spot, lie down on the ground and look at the sky. You can use our interactive meteor shower sky map or the table above to find the direction of the radiant. The higher the radiant is above the horizon, the more meteors you are likely to see. To view the Eta Aquarids, find an area well away from city lights or street lights. Come prepared with a sleeping bag, blanket, or lawn chair. Lie flat on your back with your feet facing east and look up, taking in as much of the sky as possible. After about 30 minutes in the dark, your eyes will adapt and you will begin to see meteors. Be patient, the show will last until dawn, so you have plenty of time to catch a glimpse.